What's up, you guys? It's your boy Scotty, and this is part two. This is take two because I had a whole video recorded, but at least I thought I did. Cause come to find out that the damn video never filmed, so I got to do this video all over again, and I'm really, really annoyed. But let's just get into the damn video. Let's just get this over with, cause it's like 3 o'clock and I'm like 3:36 in the morning. But yeah. The episode starts off with Tierra and Hazel. They meet up together to talk about their issues and everything like that. As we all know, last season, Tierra, Marie, and Hazel started off as very good friends from the past, you know, and present. They stayed in the same apartment, all that. But things went sour during the tattoo party that Tierra had, and then Tierra started getting involved with Young Berg during a song with him. Hazel was so crazy over Young Bird. She ain't want Young Bird fucking with nobody else. So that's just what the basis of it. And then it really came to a head when they was in New York for the reunion. And it was pretty much revealed that there was a possibility that Tierra sucked on the fun size sneaker bar. So it is what it is. So now they're at square one. Tierra reaches out to Hazel during her grandfather's death. And Hazel accepts that, and she wants to talk to Tierra, so they meet up. And apparently Tierra says that it's crazy for Hazel to even believe that shit that Young Bird said about her sucking dick in alleys. My thing about it is, Hazel, you know for yourself that Young Bird is a low-down, dirty, scum-ass nigga. All he ever does is lie. He lied about having sex with Tierra before. So why would you even sit up here and believe anything that this monkey-ass, fake-ass nigga would even say? I mean, this motherfucker gets beat up and motherfucker steal his chains, but he want to call himself a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, why would you even believe anything this motherfucking chicken wing ass nigga would even say? You know what I'm saying? Because I personally don't believe that Tierra sucked his dick. I don't believe that. I don't believe that they have a sexual relationship. I know that Bird probably wanted them to have one, but I don't believe that they had a sexual relationship. I mean, I think that something might have happened as far as, you know, Bird trying to put the moves on her, but I don't believe that Tierra sucked his dick. And I do think that Tierra and Hazel's friendship was the realest friendship on the show. And I do think that their relationship should have been, you know, A1. Because Hazel shouldn't believe nothing that Young Bird ass have to say. But all in all, they forgave each other and they're moving on. So I don't have any problems with that situation at all. So, Lava Head decides that she wants to pop up at Soulja Boy's video shoot for whatever song he got, because I ain't like no Soulja Boy song since Pretty Boy Swag, and I barely like that. So let's just say that I ain't like no Soulja Boy song since Kiss Me Through the Phone with Sat Me on there. Let's just say that. She pops up at his damn video shoot to confront him about their relationship. Now this is my thing. This bitch is the typical ho, sideline ho. Use a ho. Sideline home. When you called his phone, did he pick it up? No, cause we was making love. That's who you are. A typical sideline ass bitch. You know what I'm saying? That's what the fuck you are. Typical. Who the fuck are you to come to Soulja Boy's video shoot to confront him about his relationship with Naya? You seem to think that just because a nigga suck your pussy once or twice or for a few months, you think that that's your man. Bitch, any bitch can get their pussy sucked by a motherfucker that's not their damn man. And I think you know that, Lava Head. So why are you even sitting up here doing all the fuck shit? You know what I'm saying? Like, you already know what it is. You and that bitch Naya used to be friends. And you go and fuck her man behind her motherfucking back just because y'all not friends anymore. And then, like Soulja Boy said, you already know what it is with our relationship. You started fucking Soulja Boy when he wasn't with Naya. Look at who he with. Look at who he is. Look at who he with in public. We didn't even know who the fuck you were until you brought your ass on Love and Hip Hop and making your claim to fame as being this motherfucker's what is it, Jello on the side, his dessert on the side, when he don't like the entree sometimes. Bitch, have a seat. It's bitches like you who want to get the dick but don't know how to get the dick and shut the fuck up. If you really want this motherfucker who look like he bathes in a cesspool, then that's on you. But you need to know your motherfucking place, and however, you don't know your place. So I really think that you need to sit the fuck down and just deal with the fact that he ain't your man. He with Nia. And you got to deal with that, bitch. He don't want you like that. I mean, just because you think that because you want to, just because you seen your pussy on his face a couple of times, you seen your pussy on his on the sideburns a few times, you think that it's going to make him stay with your monkey ass. It's not going to make him stay with you. You was nothing but sideline pussy to him, and that's what you're going to forever remain. So just think, just have a seat and think about that, because you walking around making yourself look stupid. You're doing too much too soon, bitch. Have a seat. So then Nia meets up with April and I think her name was Shauna. She's Willie Taylor from Day 26's wife. She meets up with them too, and she talks about the situation. And April says, you know, this kind of comes with the territory. You know, you're dating entertainers, and you know, groupies come around and yada, yada, yada. And even though that does come with the territory, I really hate that's what these women really think they got to deal with. Like, they really got to deal with a man's cheating ways just because he's an entertainer. I feel like if you want to be community dick, then you don't need to be private property. Don't be private property when you want to be public property. Public dick, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't give a fuck if you're an entertainer. Learn how to control yourself. Just because you're an entertainer don't give you no right to go out and fuck the next bitch and then lay up with your real woman at the house and give her a damn STD. Like, that ain't cool to me, and I don't give a fuck what nobody say. It might sound unrealistic of me to say if you were entertainer you should have control. It's a lot of temptation out there, but you can also restrain yourself. It is a lot of temptation out there. When I was in my first relationship and motherfuckers didn't even want me before I got in a relationship, but once they seen me and one day tried to offer themselves it to me, it was a lot of temptation. It was tempting, but I didn't take it. Why? Because I was in love with that one person. That's who the fuck I was committed to. So at the end of the day, y'all need to stop that shit. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck about this entertainment. If you with somebody, you need to be with them. Have a seat with that, because I ain't trying to hear that shit. Off the rip, I ain't trying to hear none of that bullshit. So Nia meets up with Lavahead again. They have a conversation, and Lavahead talks about how Nia supposedly fucked two niggas that she was messing with. So that lets me know that, okay, in Nia's day, she was a thot too. But my thing about it is, whether she was a thot or not, I don't know if she was a thot or not. I don't even know if this shit this Lavahead is saying is true. But I will say this, Nia is so pretty to me, and I think that she deserves way more than motherfucking Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy looked like a damn burn. You know what I'm saying? Like a fucking burn. Like, you know how you burn yourself and then the mark stays on your leg? He looked like a nasty ass, infected ass burn on your leg. That's what the fuck he looked like. That's what you fighting over? Nia, I think that you deserve so much better than Soulja Boy, because A, he ain't gonna treat you right. He wasn't treating you right last season. And B, he gonna keep sucking on Nas's pussy long as she keep throwing it at him. So all I got to say is, Nas, you look stupid. Both of y'all look stupid fighting over this nigga, because he don't mean you no good. He watching this shit laughing. Like, y'all fighting over this motherfucker? Really? Okay. So then Fizz and Kamaya, they little storyline to me is irrelevant to anything. Like, I really don't want to talk about them. Do I have to? No. Okay, I won't be talking about them till next week, because that's when the shit gonna get interesting, because Nikki gonna be on there. So okay, so Hazel and Milan, they meet up to have a conversation, and Hazel shares with Milan that her and Tierra Marie buried the hatchet. He's not too happy to hear about that, because, you know, Hazel is his friend and Tierra already hurt Hazel and everything like that. I just gets annoyed by Milan altogether, because this motherfucker is so motherfucking fine, but so annoying at the same time. Have several and stop trying to shade Queen Tierra, motherfucker. You don't know what will happen. I mean, you do know, but stop shading the damn girl. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is the second time I've heard you shade Tierra. Keep it cute. But they talk about his situation with Miles. Malone feels like Miles is cheating on him because he hasn't been coming by the house as often as he normally has. But you should know that he's in the studio. But at the same time, even though Malone annoys me, he does have a right to have a red flag popping up. Because at the end of the day, if you are used to being with somebody every single day and hearing from them every single day, then it all falls off. Then 9 times out of 10, something is going on. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, he has a logical reason to suspect that the guy is cheating on him. So when he meets up with Miles at the house, they argue. And I do feel like Malone had every right to confront him about where the fuck he been. But at the same time, Malone, you be doing too much just because of the fact that you want this man to be who you want him to be. You want him to be out the closet because you out the motherfucking closet. But you got to understand, all of us have been in the closet before. And it's always been a process. That shit ain't easy to bring out to the forefront. And you know it's not because you've been there before. So why would you try to force somebody to do that shit? You've been there. So you should know the struggle. You should know how difficult it is. Stop trying to force this nigga to come out the motherfucking closet. If he ain't ready to come out, he ain't ready to come out. It's not like he fucking Amber. You know, he's still friends with her. But at the end of the day, I just feel like Malone is not being understanding. I get it. You want him to move in with you. You want him to do this with you. But he's not ready for it. And the more you push him, the further you're going to push his ass away. And that's all I'm saying. And they look like a dramatic couple from an episode of All My Queens or As the Queen Turns. They doing way too much. They are really doing too much. But that's all I gotta say about them. So Ray J meets up with Lil B. Her real name is Brandy. She had to let everybody know that she's the goddaughter of Whitney Houston. But I know Lil B because she was on Ray J's other reality show. I think it was For the Love of Ray J. She was doing some hosting on that show. And then, not to mention, she was on Nora's Hair Salon because she played Tamala Jones' niece, and Lil J was her love interest, but he no longer goes by Lil J. But I know he was on Hit the Floor when it first started. I don't know if he's still on there or not, but because I haven't watched Hit the Floor in a minute, but I do know that he was on there. He talks to Lil B about the situation with Tierra and Princess and how Princess and Tierra are hanging out. Lil B is shocked by that and this and that, and so Lil B was like, Princess need to watch her back with Tierra because she crazy as hell. And it just seems like, you know, all of Ray J's family and friends love Tierra a lot. They all still got respect for her, so that's good. So then that's when Lil B talks about her issues with her husband, Max. He's apparently a producer. She got an issue with him not wearing his ring to the studio, and that makes her think that he's out here doing some shit that he ain't got no business doing. Which is true. I mean, motherfucker, you married, so why you ain't wearing your motherfucking wedding ring? You know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't take much to put a damn ring on your finger. Like, if you didn't want to be married and you didn't want a ring on your finger, then you shouldn't have proposed to Lil B and asked her for your hand in marriage if you knew you weren't going to be bad, you know, doing what you're supposed to do. So, we meet Max. And then he tells Lil B that he's about to go to the studio or whatever. And Lil B was like, you know, it ain't gonna be nothing there but a bunch of bitches. But why do I feel like I've seen this storyline before on Love & Hip Hop? I think I've seen it with Chrissy and Jim. I think I've seen it with Mimi and Stevie J on the first season of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. So I just feel like I've seen this before, but whatever. But I will say this. As tiny as Lil B is and as extra and ratchet as she is, I do like her 75-pound ass. I really do like her. So, I don't know. It's kind of weird, but I think she keeps it 100. I think she does. She meets up with Nikki. And let me tell y'all something. I did not like Nikki last season, but she has really grown on me. And she messy as hell, but she's an entertaining type of messy. Like, she's not messy in a bad way. Some of that shit she being messy about needs to happen. She invited Naya to that boot camp last week. And, because she wanted her to confront Lavahead. And I thought that was genius. Like, Nikki is messy. She'll, you know, put the herbs and spices out there, stir that shit up and sit it out there and wait for that shit to cool the fuck down so the next bitch can get a taste. That's what she does, and she's very entertaining by being messy. She's just like the Hollywood Carly Red, in my opinion, but more entertaining and more likable. So, I applaud Nikki for making me like her this season, even though she being messy as hell, but I adore her this season. Go ahead, Nikki. But Nikki gets Brandy to go and stake out Max. So then they get to the studio. They bust into the wrong session, but when they finally get to the right one, they find him in the studio with Ray J, They find Maxine over there with a girl hugged up on him. She pushes her out the way, and the girl say that she didn't know that Max was married. And that's when she goes the fuck off, and that was the end of the episode. So, I'll see y'all for my Basketball Wives LA video and my Married to Madison, and I will be reviewing Empire. And I'm out of here, you guys. Peace.